COVID-19 has obviously changed aspects of our lives, especially the job industry. Employment attorney Annie Ellis is joining us now. Good morning, Annie. Good to see you.
Good morning, Lauren. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. I see your blue stuffed animals joining us again this morning. Hopefully that's not representative of all the people lined up trying to get their unemployment. Because, man, it's been a struggle. But I know we want to focus on really some of the issues that are facing the workplace, and that really speaks to employers and employees. And so I know we're following guidelines, but they seem to be changing. So one of the questions that you wanted to pose this morning is what employers and the employees should do if an employee gets a positive COVID test.
Yeah, this has been the number one question I've been getting in the last 6 weeks. And it's amazing how we went from almost no one was testing positive in the workplace to Thanksgiving and the holidays hit. And it seems like every business and employee is having someone test positive. And the first question I usually get is, well, what do we do with our workplace? What do we do with the rest of our workers? And so immediately you've got to quarantine the employee who's tested positive, and you've got to notify everyone who qualifies as a close contact, which is that definition we've been talking about for months, 6 feet, 15 minutes or more within 24 hours. And then it comes to, okay, now what do I do? What if they've been in close contact with 50 of my employees? Do I have to quarantine them? And the answer is yes. And you have to go through these procedures where you make sure that they're getting paid sick leave, and you have to go out and get them tested. And there's all these different requirements right now. And the biggest question I get is, well, we sent out all 50 to get tested. They all came back negative. Can they come back tomorrow? And the answer to that is no. They have to wait out the quarantine period, even if their doctor has cleared them. And that has been the most frustrating development for both employers and employees right now.
Yeah, I mean, that just speaks to, I think, the trust in some of the testing. But one of the big things is that the federal paid sick leave expired December 31st. So what does that mean for paid sick leave now?
Yeah, great question. So the Family First Coronavirus Response Act required federal paid sick leave for COVID-19 related issues through December 31st. It was a requirement, and you got a tax credit for it as a business owner. Now it's discretionary through March 31st. So you can provide it if you want to and get the tax credit, or unfortunately, employees are going to have to dip into their personal paid sick leave banks that are mandated by the state of California or the county of San Diego if they want to get paid or use their vacation. And that's been another pretty frustrating development.
And what about with the vaccines coming out? I mean, we're not quite there yet with sort of the general population, if you will. But we've talked about this issue of whether or not employers can require employees to get a COVID vaccine.
Right. So the number one question has been what to do when someone tests positive, and this one's creeping in. I think it's going to overtake that first question as we start to get more industries, having access to the vaccine. And the answer is the federal government, the EEOC, has said you can mandate it. You have to allow for religious and medical exceptions. So, for example, I'm pregnant, and if my employer came to me and said you have to take the vaccine, I think the answer to that would probably be no, unless my doctor signed off on it. But we don't have any way in yet from the state of California, and we all know that the state of California often does things different from the federal government. So it's possible that they're going to come out and say, you know, for regular industries that aren't healthcare related, the ones that are in the tier one right now, may not be able to require it. So that's something that we're watching pretty closely. So for now, just tread very carefully.
All right. Annie Ellis, always appreciate you having wise words for us during this, and certainly appreciate it. I know we'll have you back with more of these frequently asked questions as we get them in. So thank you.
Thanks, Lauren.
Have a great day.